in vogue today, really relevant. I love Catherine Hepburn bobs. I love old-fashioned Louise Brooks bobs. I love SpongeBob. He's my son's favorite, you know? Uncle Bob. All right, now see all this heavy hair here? I want to disconnect it with this section, but I don't want that heaviness. So what we're going to do is we know if we cut it too short and the client has a broad cranium, which she does not, she's got a great head shape. We're going to be very careful that we don't cut this too short. So I'm going to put the head up in the upright position now, not down, but up. And I'm just going to take this section. I'm going to lift it up. I'm going to look at where the hair drops out underneath, which is right about there. Take my scissors, and I'm just going to pull the hair out to right about here, and I'm going to drop it and see where it falls, see if I like that. So I'm going to take this section, I'm going to go ahead and cut it, and once again, oh, that sounds like a roller coaster ride. That's where I'm cutting it, 2 or 3 inches off, take a look, see where the hair falls. I kind of like that, so we'll just keep it right there. I'm going to over-direct every section into that section. And I'm rotating my hands to facilitate the cutting. I've got to tell you something. People always ask me, Eric, is it okay if you move your hands once you grip the hair? If you comb the hair and you've got a good grip on the hair, then you can relax your hands. As long as the grip is still really, really tight. See, my grip is still tight. If you're a little shorter or you've got a really tall client, it's very important to utilize this technique.